absolutely amazing dance moves we just saw there. I mean, some of the best. Round of applause.
They're going to Toronto, man.
You are making the finals. That is impressive. I'm Goatman.
And I'm Lunch.
And this is Anoka News. And today, we're going to Lauren's volleyball game.
Have you heard about it?
I've heard about Lauren's volleyball game.
What is it?
Lauren's volleyball game.
It's Lauren's volleyball game. But let's get down to the real business.
When your teacher powers off the news, you'll have one class period standing between you and a four-day break. That's because Monday is President's Day. Before we head out for the long weekend, let's take a moment to run today's Black History highlight on the Duke.
Duke Ellington at Jazz Luncheon revolutionized the genre with his innovative compositions and charismatic performances. His musical genius and ability to blend different styles created a unique sound that captivated audiences worldwide. From Take the A, Train, to Mood Indigo, Ellington's compositions continue to be celebrated as masterpieces. His influence on jazz and popular music is immeasurable, solidifying his place as one of the most influential musicians of the 20th century.
Thanks for the spotlight, the Duke. Pretty soon there will be a spotlight shining on some of your Anoka actors. And if you want to be one of them, you got to audition. Auditions for the spring musical, Shrek, will happen on Monday, February 26th at 2:45 in the orchestra room. You should prepare 30 seconds to 1 minute of a song of your choice, and you should bring the music sheet for the song. If you need any help finding a song, or if you have any questions about the audition process, please get a hold of Mr. Manns or Mrs. Hayes.
I'd personally recommend doing a Smash Mouth song. I mean, that's the safe bet. Also happening on the 26th, the National Honor Society 2024 induction ceremony with guest speaker Mr. Bowman. This is an event meant to celebrate the new members of the society and the four pillars of the NHS scholarship service: leadership and character.
A different type of scholarship that's closing soon is the Anoka High School Scholarship application, which gives you access to over 70 different scholarships. The deadline is next Wednesday, February 21st, so get it done as soon as possible. Please see Ms. Neary in the College and Career Center. Tonight, there aren't any clubs taking place, but they'll be back next week on Wednesday after the much-needed four-day break.
Now, before we take a break for sports, let's run down the lunch menu.
Lunch.
Today, the cafeteria...
No. Let me say it. Today, the cafeteria is serving up chicken tenders, spicy chicken wraps, and a vegetarian salad. Oh my God. Let's throw the ball to Luma with the weekend sports update.
Tonight, both the gymnast team and the wrestling team compete in a section play. The Brawlers bus to Elk River High School for the 7AAA team tournament, and the gymnast team travels to Cambridge, Isani. Let's check in with the Brawlers before they do the battle up north.
Hi, we're here with three varsity Brawlers. What are your names?
Luke Deshane.
Ian Whittick.
And Wyatt Rothram.
Obviously, they've had a great season. They have sections coming up, so just talk about it, like what day it is and stuff.
It's today at Elk River High School, and the first round starts at 4 p.m.
Finals are at 7.
We'll be wrestling Blaine first round, and then the winner of Cambridge versus Elk River second round.
So make sure to show out. What can we like expect to see there?
You can expect to see great matches, some hard fighting between all teams, and, you know, just your brawlers brawling.
Yes, sir.
A lot of tough competition. Definitely going to get heated in the finals match. Just a fun time. Definitely pop out.
Some W's.
Yes, sir. Can we show us some examples of some of your wrestling moves? We have a test dummy right here, Greg. So you can just try it on him.
I'll be showing a lat drop.
How'd that feel?
You know what? If that was quick, that'd be pretty scary. But, you know, it wasn't that bad. It just hurt my thigh a little bit.
Is it safe there, Greg? We're only doing one move.
No. Oh. I'm willing to do two. I'm not scared. Just let me recover a bit. That's all.
Recover?
Like 2 months.
Thanks for the info, guys. Also taking place tonight, the boys and girls basketball team tip off against OCO. The girls are at home and the boys are away. Then tomorrow morning, the speech team makes their way over to Forest Lake for the next competition of the season. The boys volleyball team is looking forward to starting their season soon. Here they are with some info.
What's good, Anoka? I'm Shozi, and I'm here with...
My name is Mark.
My name is Sid.
Both of them are on the boys' volleyball team, and their season is starting up real soon. What can you guys tell us about the new season?
So on Wednesday, February 21st at 7:15 a.m., we have our first informational meeting in B204. We want all of you guys to be there, and you could learn more about the team and how the season is going to go.
And our first two open gym volleyball practices will be on February 27th and March 7th.
And we hope to see all of you guys there.
That's it, Anoka. Make sure everyone that can join boys volleyball, please join. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks, Mark. Finally, remember that registration for spring sports is underway. Have a great weekend. Back to Goldman and lunch.
Thank you so much for the rundown, Luma. We're going to close today's show with, well, you will see. I'm Goatman.
And I'm Lunch.
And guess what? Mark Milbauer is honestly just a really great teacher, you know? Every time I've had his class, which is 5 times now, has been just an absolutely phenomenal experience. I mean, when Milbauer gets a class, it really just changes your life. It really just has you doing stuff that you never really thought you would do before. I mean, an acting class is truly something that just changes the world and changes the people around you. The group connection is just so great, and all those people, all the different people.
Hey, y'all, I'm here with
Colleen.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what would you rate my accent?
A 10.
All right, can we hear your best accent?
I was walking to the supermarket the other day, and me and my auntie Mary, okay, and I, we had a Hootenberry down at the rodeo.
Really?
And it was really fun. But wow. Yeah.
Thank you, Sugar. I really appreciate it. You
Thank
did
you.
Great.
Thank you.
Who am I here with today?
Miss Benson. Hello.
Miss Benson, how good is my accent from 1 to 10?
What accent is it? Just like Southern?
I don't know. I guess so.
I think like a 7.
All right. All right. Can you do your accent for me? Just about anything.
Just about anything.
About anything.
My name is Miss Benson, and I'm from Minnesota, and I've lived here my whole life.
Is that how Minnesotans talk?
No. Well, that went British a little bit.
I'm here with
Nicole,
Malaysia,
Maria.
And what do y'all rate my accent 1 through 10?
I rate your accent about like an 8. I'm from Texas, actually, if y'all can't tell.
Okay.
Hey, y'all. We triplets. I rate your accent a 9 out of 10. Mm-hmm. I rate it about... A 10, a good 10.
Yeah. A 10, okay.
All right, babies. I was going to ask y'all to do your own accent, but I already hear y'all already doing it.
Yeah.
Who am I here with today?
Barrett.
Sequoia.
Rate my accent 1 through 10.
Can you say, can I have some biscuits and gravy?
Can I have some biscuits and gravy?
I'd say like a solid like 7.2.
I would say 7.5.
Okay, honey. Can you do an accent for me?
Yeah, sure. Do you want to go first?
No, you got that. Okay.
Give me an accent to do.
British.
Does anyone have some crumpets and tea?
Excuse me, love. Can I get an apple, please?
Okay.
Radars out of 10.
You, I'd have to say like a...
A limb?
A 6.3. You, honey. No.
Let me do
no.
A
limb. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Boom.
11, 10, 9, 8.
No, rate that. Rate that. Well, Vicky.
That was my fantastic, dear. That was like an 11.
The bass main, the bass get lower. Radio say speed it up. I just go slower. High like treble, puffing on the muse. The man ain't ever seen the booty like this. And why you think you keep my name rolling off the tongue? When you wanna smash, I just write another.